This video will discuss the functionality of the CD requirements report. From an empty speed screen with no items on the left-hand side, bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for options, so click on the options button. Middle portion of your screen, under the open line column, last button, you're going to see a reports button, so click on the reports button. Left-hand side, seven buttons down, you're going to see a historical button, so click on the historical button. Right-hand side, you're going to see an up and down arrow, so click on the down arrow. Middle portion of your screen, fourth column, fourth button, you're going to see CDM requirements report, so click on the CDM requirements report button. Bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a sample report. You're going to see departments, server, bartender, seats, width, total, and percentage. Bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for dates, so click on the dates button. Please select date range for your report. We have start date and end date. For this particular discussion, we have a start date of November 16th of last year, 2011, and end date of November 30th, 2012. We are going to print this particular report for the entire business day. If you want to print this report for specific time periods, click off entire business day, and you can enter a start time or an end time. We're going to stick with the entire business day. Click on entire business day, see a check mark appear. Right hand side of your screen, you're going to see a button for OK, so click on the OK button. Bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for run, so click on the run button. You can select all the departments or you can select a specific department. For this example, we're going to click on beer. On the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for select all items or unselect all items. We're going to stick with beer for the department. Right next to the unselect all items button, you're going to see an OK button, so click on the OK button. We need to select categories. There's three under the department of beer. We have bottled beer, domestic beer, and draft beer. Bottom portion of your screen, we're going to click on the select all items button. Bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a button for OK, so click on the OK button. And here is the seating requirements report. One functionality of this particular report is you can see how many seats ordered at least one beer. There is specific information you will find on the seating requirements report. You'll see who ran the report, what station the report was run from, the date, the time, the date range, the department, the categories, the server, the seats, width and total and percentage. For example, Andy Admin sat for total 33 people. Out of those 33 people, 8 ordered at least one beer, which was 24.2%. Marty the manager sat 2 and only 1 ordered at least one beer item. On the bottom portion of your screen, you're going to see a note. The width count is the number of seats with one or more matching items. This is not a count of matching items. So the numbers you see under the width column, for example, Andy Admin, 8 out of 33 ordered some type of beer, bottled beer, domestic beer, or draft beer. At least one. It does not tell you how many more that individual ordered. It just states at least one. On the bottom portion of your screen, you can see that you can print the report, you can email the report, or you can save the report to a file. In the bottom right-hand corner, you're going to see a button for close, so click on the close button. Bottom right-hand corner, you're going to see a button for close, so click on the close button. And that is the functionality of the seating requirements report within 2Touch.